Hey there, bold move makers, and those people who are no longer going to stay in the closet. You're not going to be those closet dwellers. It is time for a life uncloseted rip and rap. I'm your host, Rick Clemens, and today I want to talk about a fuck it bucket. Yes, I said that. A fuck it bucket. And this is part one of the fuck it bucket. And what I love about fuck it buckets, and I use this with clients all the time, is they can actually serve two purposes. So we're going to start with the fuck it bucket that is about, what do you want to get rid of? Because the fuck it bucket of getting rid is going to help you in so many ways. It's going to help you answer the question, if this wasn't in my life, what would be different? So for instance, the first thing that you can throw in a fuck it bucket to help you start getting rid of stuff that doesn't work in your life and to keep from doing these things that impede on you being so totally yourself and living a bold life, is to put anything in the fuck it bucket that is a waste of energy. If it's talking on the phone, if it's too much social media, if it's gossiping about other people, if it's comparing yourself to others, it needs to go in the fuck it bucket. The second thing that needs to go in your fuck it bucket, or at least what I believe is a great thing to throw in your fuck it bucket, is anything that doesn't thrill you. If something doesn't excite you, if it doesn't make you happy, if it doesn't give you joy, if it doesn't make you want to be alive, and I don't mean go commit suicide, that's not where I'm going, but if it doesn't give you that, like, oh man, I really enjoy this. Now, I know there's going to be some things in life that aren't super enjoyable, but I'm talking about the bigger things. Like, man, if you're not doing it and it doesn't thrill you, then throw it in the fuck it bucket. Get it out of the way because you need to make room for something that really does thrill you. The third thing that I find that's helpful to throw in your fuck it bucket is anything that is burning you out. Anything that's causing you to burn those candles at both ends or multiple ends, or that's causing you to go, I'm so drained and I'm never happy. Now that may be something that's similar to something that doesn't thrill you, but I really want you to look deeper and look at what are the sort of things that are burning me out on a regular basis. I know at one point in my life, the thing that was burning me out was teaching too many spin classes. At one point, I was teaching like between 10 to 15 spin classes a week. And while I loved teaching spin classes, it was burning me out. It was making me so tired, and I wasn't getting enough sleep, and I wasn't taking care of my body. I wasn't having time to recoup and refuel my body. I looked great. At some point, I actually looked kind of scary because I'd lost so much weight, but it was burning me out. The next thing I suggest that you throw in your fuck it bucket is anything that lacks direction. Now, that doesn't mean, well, I don't really know where I'm going. I don't know if I can figure this out. No, those things that are just beginning, give them some space. But I'm talking about anything that says, this is going nowhere. This doesn't look like it's going to end where I want it to go. If it's really unclear and you've been working on it, or if it's really unclear from the get-go that it's going to get you where you're going, put it in the fuck it bucket. And finally, and this is a big one that I know many, many people, I'm an obliger. Yes, I know I stumbled over my words there, but I am an obliger according to Gretchen Rubin's Four Tendencies. And I know this, that if I'm doing it for others and not for myself, I have a tendency to just really hate stuff. Now, that doesn't mean I don't enjoy doing things for other people. I love doing things for other people. But when it's something that I'm constantly doing for others that I don't really want to be doing, that takes away from my energy, that doesn't bring me joy, that isn't something that I can see is mutually beneficial, but I'm doing it just because other people expect me to do it, it needs to go in the fuck it bucket. Because remember, you have to ask yourself this one question. If I keep doing this, what's the benefit of it to my life? If you keep doing it, is it a waste of energy? If you keep doing it, is it going to not thrill you? If you keep doing it, is it going to burn you out? If you keep doing it, is it going to keep causing you to lack direction? If you keep doing it for others and not yourself, what is going to be the end result? So that's it. That is part one of the fuck it bucket. And I want you to really work through that. If you need to rewind and re-listen to this podcast, I encourage you to do that, because you need to kind of get a handle on these things before you go on to part two that is coming 1 week from now. Not the next show, but a week from now. So you're going to be wanting to tune back in to the fuck it bucket where we go for it. And that's it. I'm Rick Clemons, the host of Life Uncloseted Riff and Rants, and I can't wait to talk to you again real soon. Take care and have a good week.